say which oxidize to provide you energy, that is known as respiratory substrate. What it is known as? Respiratory. In the compound which are needed for the oxidation or for to release the energy, that known as respiratory substrate. So here which is used as a respiratory? Glucose. So glucose is respiratory substrate. Cellular respiration means like when the glucose oxidizes or when glucose burn in presence of oxygen, at the time energy is released, and that energy is in the form of a chemical that is known as ATP, adenosine triphosphate. What is the full form of ATP? Adenosine triphosphate. Energy is released in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. And how much energy is released in one respiration when the one glucose is burned? Means one glucose burned at that time, how much energy is released? 686 kilocalorie per mole. How much is released? 38 ATP, but kilocalorie or in place molecules, you can say 38. Means like C6H12O6 plus 6 oxygen. What we get? 6 molecule of carbon dioxide and?
6
molecule of carbon. And how much energy? 686 kilocalorie per mole or 2880 kilojoule. This much energy is released when the one molecule of glucose is oxidized. Earlier we have discussed in the form of numbers, means how many number of ATPs, how many molecules of ATPs are released. So we know how many? 38. And in anaerobic respiration, how many molecules?
Two.
And this ATP is act as a energy currency of the cell. Like you people are using currency to purchase something, so cell's currency is this only. So ATP is also called energy currency of cell. What it is called? So whenever our body requires energy, at that time this ATP hydrolyzes and it provides energy to the body. So what's going with the ATP? ATP undergoes hydrolysis. And as a result, what we get? Energy. And that energy, body use for different metabolic processes. Yes? So body use that energy for different metabolic processes. So this ATP goes undergoes hydrolysis. As a result, what form? ADP, inorganic phosphate,
ADP.
When it's hydrolyzed, ADP means this is adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate. You can write. Adenosine diphosphate, then phosphate, and energy. When ATP hydrolyzed, we get one molecule of ADP, phosphate, one molecule of phosphate, and then energy. Fine. Now, organ of respiratory tract. You know what are those? Nose? Yes? Nose having nostril and nasal cavity. Then respiratory tract. Am I not noting down? You are not noting down the thing? Then trachea. Trachea divided into bronchi or one is bronchus. Bronchi is plural because trachea divided into two right and left tubes, that is right bronchus and left bronchus, and together we say bronchi. Then bronchioles, then alveoli, alveolar sac you can say, then alveoli, lungs. Respiratory muscles. It's muscles of breathing which help in respiration. Muscles of breathing. What are those? Intercostal muscle and bronchioles, alveolar sac, alveoli, lungs. Yes, bronchus. One is bronchus. Means bronchus is singular, bronchi is plural. They are having
one lung is larger than
the other. Two lobe, three leg lobe stuff. Pleura. Pleura is membrane. Covering. Pleural fluid is also there. Diaphragm, we know, it's a room shape. Muscular structure which helps you in breathing. Intercostal muscles are the muscles between the ribs. They have pulling movement of the rib. Here, this is called this one. Trachea and bronchus. Together they form what they call tracheobronchiolar tree. Why tracheobronchiolar tree? Because sort of tree, sort of a structure in the lung. One means bronchi is divided into bronchioles and then the alveoli. Tracheobronchial tree. From trachea to the all part, they come into lower respiratory tract. They are the upper respiratory tract till the larynx, larynx or voice box. So upper respiratory tract and lower respiratory tract. So what are the different part of the respiratory system? Nose. Nose having nostril and nasal cavity, and then pharynx and larynx, then trachea, bronchi, bronchiole, alveolar sac. Alveolar sac is actually the bunch of alveoli, and of course a pair of lungs. These all the things are there in the lung. You cannot say alveolar means even the outer covering gone and just the tracheobronchial tree is just hanging in the, that's not lungs. It's lungs, its own function is there. It's, lungs is, no, you cannot say that tracheobronchial tree is a lung only. Although it's there in the lung, because you know it's covered by a pleural membrane, that this is double membrane. It's having a fluid inside, pleural fluid, and that helps to lubricate the lungs, that helps to reduce the resistance by movement, and that gives the covering. Yes. So here, these are the organs of respiratory tract.